Hi, friends. Welcome back to Alice Playworld, bringing you some more Heroes of the Storm. Today we're playing my newfound love, Lt.Morales. Welcome to the Battlefield of Eternity. Enemy team Greymane, Falsat, Zul, Uther, and Nova. Friendly team Lee Main, Garrison, Milliden, Val, and Morales. Oh my god. Matchmaking seriously does not want me to have a good game. This will be very interesting. At the very least, we can keep Milliden alive, and maybe we'll use a sim drone to some effect. For Morales, let's go over our abilities really quickly. Q is called Healing Beam. Heal an ally for 200 health a second. As long as they are in range, reactivate to switch targets. Or activate your trait to cancel the channel. That's, of course, Caddy's reactor will regenerate 3% of your maximum health every second after not taking damage for 4 seconds. So, theoretically, if we're really good with that position, we'll self-heal by being in the back. Our W ability is called Safeguard. Grant target ally resistant, which reduces their damage taken by 25% for 3 seconds. Our E ability is called Grenade of Fun. No, just kidding, it's called Displacement Grenades. But it is a Grenade of Fun. As you will throw it, it does knock people back. The first time we're going to be picking up, I think, is going to be Trauma Trigger. Activates our W on ourselves at 50 below health. The problem is the enemy team is really divey, so if I get stunned, I'm not going to have a chance to react there with Uther and whatnot. So we'll do that and try to keep Illidan alive right here. See if he begins to engage. And of course, the whole thing about the medic is to try to be as patient with your mana as possible. As you can see there, I'm not healing anybody because we do have Charism on this side, and he will be auto-healing for a little bit, so no need to go there. I doubt that's the real Nova. I mean, Illidan got really excited about it. We will heal him a little bit as she does pop her entire rotation on her. But really not much else to do here other than just sit here and watch as the enemy team is going to try to defend. So we're going to go really aggressive. Illidan unable to catch her there in the back. And of course, keep an eye on the minimap, seeing if Lee Ming can hold her own up there. She should be able to. Theoretically speaking, of course, that again, not the real Nova. It looks like the friendly Illidan being very confused by all this. And right now, we're going to be using a little bit of our mana to make sure these guys are topped off because, of course, remember, the enemy team is very divey. They do have a Falstad who can do a ton of damage on top of that in Nova. So we're going to just try to make things easier on the monk. We still have the healing well. So as long as we're sitting in the back here, that's not too bad. We will displace them a little bit, although good Zul minions that will interrupt momentarily. And we got to be very, very careful about this. It looks like Illidan, again, trying to jump in super deep. We do have a lot of healing on him, though. If they keep trying to focus him, this is going to be perfectly fine because I can actually do quite a bit. The monk has a lot of sustain. He is going to be going damage in all likelihood here, because we do have two supports. It would be silly for him not to do so, but he still provides a lot of utility with that Breath of Heaven and, of course, the dashes. So we're going to try to go here and go as aggressive as possible on the... are these Immortals or Punishers? I forget which ones these are. Immortals, they are fighting to sit right there on the bottom side of the screen. We'll try to out-DPS the enemy team because if you try to defend, it's going to be very difficult for us to dive. So at the very least, we will get the damage done. Make sure we hook up with Li Ming. She should be low on health and mana, but she should be able to back away. And we will be able to top her off momentarily. Of course, throwing that W there on Illidan, making sure we keep him topped off as he's going super ham. But we ourselves are going to be able to keep him really, really healthy. We are going to get stunned there. Quite on purpose, if you ask me. I just didn't want to end up on the opposite side. Remember, 4 seconds of no damage, we will begin to heal rather aggressively. And we should be able to out-DPS the enemy team here really, really quickly, although they do almost get those shields down. So for now, I will back up and make sure I get enough mana to support the push. Sticking that stat, 0 kills to 0 so far, so good. 6,900 damage for Vala on our team, 5,000 damage for Zul. Honorable mentions is us with 91 damage. We've only landed one grenade. One of the cool things about the medic is that you can actually get away with not doing much damage at all because your positioning is so much more important than the measly damage that you afford that sometimes you don't want to right click, but don't get me wrong, you should. You should be doing damage to the medic, don't slack. The next time we're going to be picking up is going to be... okay, so let's see. I think I'm going to grab Block. I think that's going to be one of the things that's going to keep me alive in this game when they decide they can't kill Illidan or at least they can't burst him through my nonsense. So we will try our best to try to do that. See if we can get something going on. Of course, it looks like Uther getting caught up position right there. We will throw out yet another grenade. That will get him stunned a little bit. But the enemy team are dealing with that immortal really, really quickly. And now we're going to be forced to back up here for a moment. Because we really couldn't get much out of it. But we are slightly ahead of experience. So that's nice. So all in all, not too bad. We will hit them a little bit of a grenade. Trying to pad our stats a little bit. It looks like Illidan on the bottom here. Trying to secure these minions. We will give him a little bit of shielding. That's all he needs to save our mana, because remember, he does do quite a bit of healing, although it looks like our friendly Vala on the top lane gets taken down, and that is not great. Oh, I messed that up. I messed that up terribly. At the very least, I'm going to be taking some damage here, but again, not a big deal, because we will be able to heal up momentarily here. As soon as we capture this, we will have a little bit of a push, and we will be able to respond in kind. It looks like Li Ming going super aggressive right there. Trying to top her off and trying to make sure the enemy team doesn't get too cute. We also got to keep an eye on the enemy Nova. She can actually blow us up quite a bit. That's why we picked up Safeguard, actually. So if she opens up on us, it's not the end of the world, but it's also not great. It looks like Li Ming gonna want to begin to snipe here. I think that's a perfectly reasonable thing to do. We will throw a max range grenade just to poke a little bit and make sure we're within range of her. So we want to make sure we can run in and heal her. We also want to make sure that if they open up on us, we're not gonna get taken down. Look at that. There we go. Perfect. Looks like our precision so far so good. But these minions not really gonna be able to do anything. The enemy team counteracting them quite nicely. Zero kills to one, of course. 9,000 kill damage for Zul, 12,000 damage for Vala. It looks like the friendly team will have to go down. Oh, let's go really aggressive, really right here against this Nova, which is not the real Nova. I thought he had caught her. But at the very least, we'll keep Illidan alive. We'll make sure we get some minions. We might be able to hit up the healing wall because this will. We're fine. Actually, we'll save the cooldown. I thought we would have 30 seconds. So now again, we got to try to out DPS the enemy team. We do have a level advantage and a talent, so maybe we want to fight. Next time we're going to be picking up is going to be... I think we're going to do the damage aura, because of course that is going to keep our Illidan doing a lot more damage. So we're going to be aggressive and then just shove Sewell deep into his base. Just show him what's up. And now, of course, trying to rotate us here as fast as possible. The enemy team already beginning on our Immortal, which means we're going to have not a lot of time to do damage here. Got to make sure we get in here. I'm actually going to pop that Q on Illidan. Remember, we do have the damage aura going on. It's going to help us out a little bit, and we did have the mana to spare it. However, the enemy team beating us really, really badly to that halfway point, and now we definitely got to come in here and flex for the defense. Got to make sure we keep an eye on Illidan. He's going super deep. Make sure we heal him up. He's going to go really, really deep over there in the back against Uther. Go ahead and throw out that grenade. Just trying to flex a little bit. Oh, can we get to the monk? Looks like he's very low. I'm going to try to switch to Illidan because he made it out alive. And Illidan is my main priority. I need to keep him alive. It looks like we are going to keep both of them alive. And now switching here to the monk, making sure he gets stopped off. As I continue to put that W on Illidan just to make sure that he can dive the backline there. But I am very, very low on health and mana. Sorry, in mana. So I'm going to try to stay alive here for a second. Let my teammates know that I'm going here really quickly to hit up the mana well and then return. It looks like we do catch a little bit of flak. Illidan in the backline by himself. Should be able to dive. I am going to put a little bit of a safeguard on him, and with him and me by ourselves, we should be able to defend this. Of course, jumping back in here on the monk. Oh, I'm trying to keep that up. That faucet got a lot of damage out of that, so we're still sort of being aggressive, and we will be able to pick up a kill on Nova. I maybe would have been able to save that Li Ming, but aren't able to do much else. And we're going to just try to keep these guys away, making sure that they're not doing too much damage to our immortal, but they are continuing to push really aggressively. So I'm going to try to stay here and defend as Illidan does a little bit of damage, but I really don't know if I got anything else here. We'll be able to block this guy away and then do a little bit of healing down on the monk as we're getting attacked quite severely. We will try to keep ourselves topped up, but I'm completely out of mana, so it looks like the enemy team's gonna get this immortal before we can do anything else, unless it looks like Vala won't be able to do much. Vala's gonna try to come in here and be queued. We're very much and we might be able to flex on them at the end and maybe pick up a triple kill. That would be huge. But I'm trying desperately to get Illidan and do my healing beam. Remember, I am very much out of mana. And the moment that he walks away from my range means he's getting absolutely no heals. But we do pick up a triple kill. Level 9 to level 9, they do get an immortal. And our Li Ming, super aggressive on the backside, trying to pick up some kills, or at least checking the bush for Nova. It looks like she'll be able to get away. Nova missing the snipe at the last second. Oh, Li Ming. I'm going to try to let her know that I'm coming. She can get away. Maybe we can heal her up. Well, of course, Nova going to be keen to chase. She's right behind her. So she needs to keep moving and not look back. The enemy team finally unable to get another pick on us. And we should be able to clear this out without much contention. We maybe will take a little bit of damage on this other tower. But as you can see, there are no big deal as Illidan continues to chase. And that is really, really, really deep. Okay, let's go ahead and make sure he's topped off. Trying to stay with him. Finally, level 10. You know what I mean. Stim Drone. I love the medivac, but Stim Drone is just so filthy good on Illidan. So we're going to do just that. Throwing out the little heal here just to make sure that we get a little bit more damage. And that's about enough because we don't really want to waste too much mana. Keep an eye on the minimap. 5 kills to 3. 21,000 damage for Vala. 16,000 damage for Zul. So far, so good. How are we doing healing wise? 19,000 to Uther. 17,000. That's not too bad. That's not too bad. That's not great, but it's not too bad either. We're going to keep Illidan alive here. He took the full volley of Vala, and he seems to be doing fine. And if these guys want to dive, we should definitely push this fort as aggressively as we can. Of course, big grenade. We do catch Nova there at the mag site. I saw her, and I was like, you know what? This is going to be great. It's going to be great. I'm actually going to keep these guys alive. This is really BM what I'm doing, but it's actually totally worth it because these guys are quite tanky. And if you can keep them topped off, you can actually do quite a bit of damage. Of course, Zul going back there of Vala. She will chunk her a little bit, but we're completely fine so far. And we're going to be forced to retreat as they finally hit that level 10. Based on the timing, I am going to top myself up with mana because the cooldown will be back in a second. Me and myself and Illidan can get another pick here. Excuse me, and get some more minions. Of course, the next one is going to be crucial. Looks like Greymane going super aggressive. Oh my god, Illidan going the hammest ham of all hams. And he's going to get taken down super aggressive unnecessarily. 1v5'd. And there's really not much else we can do here. We can just try to keep our charism alive and then maybe poke a little bit. The enemy team doing a good job of stealing those marks from us. As we're going to sit here and try to just clear them out really quickly before the 5 seconds we got till the next one. And of course, these guys got to die because now they're going to break through and break our wall. And then on top of that, break our healing wall. And it's going to be defend till Illidan gets here. Not much else to do except for just a big, big poke. We will land a good grenade there, trying to keep Vala alive. She used continue to poke and consistently our top damage. Make sure we do that. Let's go ahead and put that drone on Illidan and then let him go to town. Although he needs to be really cautious about how far away he is from his healers. He keeps going super hard, and now we're trying to keep him up as he's doing the majority of the damage here. But we also got to keep Vala alive. We got to keep everybody else alive while they continue to push. That precision strike going to do a ton of damage, but Illidan continued to chase. Got to put that again on him. We will auto-attack a couple times to pick up a kill on Uther. And now trying to top off the Monk, although we are very low on damage. This chase is real. Will we be able to pick up a kill? It looks like a lot of damage going out. We will actually pop that grenade on the top lane. It looks like we pick up yet another kill on Zul, but I am very much out of mana. Got to be very careful about this. I will try to assist the team into DPS in this, but just right-clicking as hard as I can, maybe throwing the eventual grenade. But as soon as this is dead, I need to make sure I hurry on back and pick up a little bit of mana because I am completely tapped out. Let's go ahead and head in the bush. We're gonna be bold. We're gonna be daring. We're gonna back right there. Hopefully Noah does not catch us. And we should be able to hit up mana as soon as we're a little bit topped off. We're gonna wait till right about now. There we go. We'll just run back to see if we can help out the front team with quite a sizable lead. So I doubt they're gonna need any help DPSing that down. But there might be an engagement as soon as this immortal is dead. So we wanna make sure we're nearby to assist when they go get those, of course, healing orbs in the middle. Gotta be very careful about that. They have a Nova and we're not really respecting her, which is a little bit of an issue. Any one of us can get into a lot of trouble if a pinning shot gets landed. And of course, the enemy team descends on us. Looking at stats now, 7 kills to 4. It's just basically that triple kill we got in the middle is all the difference she wrote. And Illidan doing a good job, but we're gonna wish that he was a little bit more careful with his engagements, because of course, he goes way too deep. And then there's not much we can do. Zul with a counter. They're trying to counter him a little too early. That's the other problem. The enemy team not really able to dive like they want to. And of course, big engagement here. We are going to get taken back. Oh, precision strike is severe. But here comes the Sim Drone. Nova in a lot of trouble. Let's go ahead and pick up the back line. Make sure everybody's healed up over here. Hopefully, there is a Palm. I'm going to try to get to Illidan. He's going so deep. I'm going to try to keep him alive. The enemy team. Oh, great Palm there at the end. We do pick up a kill right there. Can we keep him alive? No, we cannot. We definitely cannot. Illidan going way too difficult. And now I'm going to try to keep the Monk alive for 1 second. But all our carries very, very low. They keep getting chunked there. Big chunks of damage at a time. And we got to be very, very, very careful with our mana from now on. Because, of course, this Immortal is going to die. We're going to be forced to back away. And hopefully none of us get caught out of position. Although, ooh, very, very close. It looks like Li Ming should be able to back away. And for now, no. We're doing a little bit of damage, but not dismounting Vala. That was weird. The next time we're going to be picking up is going to be, I think, intensive care. Healing increases over time. I think that's the only way we're actually going to get away with this Illidan staying alive. If we can put that beam on him and then just keep it on him for a long time. 37,000 healing, though. 33,000 for, of course, Uther, and 27,000 for the Monk, as he did not pick up that passive that auto-heals. That's why he's not on the top of the charts. But so far, 8 kills to 5. 35,000 damage for Vala. 31,000 for Zul. How's our Illidan doing? 19,000, but he does have 5 killing blows. So that's a little, you know, don't go for the numbers too much. Because, of course, a lot of this other damage from Vala and Li Ming. And, it looks like Vala about to get taken down. Can I make it there in time? So we're going to try to run back here. Noah might be the one trying to dive this. We gotta make sure we actually keep her topped off in case anything scary happens. The Monk showing up here at the last second might be able to do a little bit by revealing the enemy team, but of course they're diving this. There's not much we can do, and the Monk is gonna die. Yeah, I was gonna try to heal him. There's nothing to do here. He gets completely destroyed. We might be able to top it all off, and of course we do lose that fort, although we do take the bottom one. So 1-for-1, not too bad, but this mercenary push has got to be dealt with. It is a little scary. We aren't able to really secure anything there. I might actually just give the Syndrome to Vala next fight. I think that might be the sensible thing to do. She's doing a lot more damage. He might be able to flex a little bit more. And Illidan, to be fair, perfectly honest, is a little too divey for my taste. I don't think I can afford to continue to dive through everything just to keep him up. Because, of course, no one else is getting healing while I'm going through the enemy team just to keep Illidan relatively alive. So we will see how the fight goes. In fact, we will do it now. I'm just going to give her the Stim Drone right now. Keep her topped off. Make sure you give Illidan a little bit of healing. And then, of course, run back as we're going to just go super aggressive. The enemy team unable to really out DPSs, particularly with the Stim Drone. We make it to 50% rather quickly. And, of course, we got to be careful. The real Nova is right up there. Although the front team not really seeing her at the moment. We could have picked her up with a little bit of damage. Multi-shot would have been nice. But for now, we will just go super deep. I'm throwing a Frantic Grenade through the smoke here. See if we can keep anything else up. And of course, here comes the healing. Oh, Fawcett trying to do a little bit of damage there on the top. But we're just going to out-DPS him really, really thoroughly, it seems like. Although that stun on Volog made it really close. We still pick up the kill. Secured him back away. The enemy team very, very close to getting away with it. For now, we'll back away here. Let's go ahead and throw a grenade in the back line. Punishing these guys and making sure they top off. Everybody else is gaining their mana back. We should be able to hook up with the friendly team on the bottom lane and see how it goes. The next time we're going to be picking up at level 16 is going to be, I think, Inoculation trying to save people with that W, although I could not land it on the Monk because he gets chunked so easily. But if we can land it, we might keep somebody alive, and that might be all we need. Of course, big engagement here on the bottom lane as the enemy team begins to get taken down. Sewell might try to go for me, but I don't really think he will, as he is really much out of position. Get involved and make something happen. Excuse me as I burp, cough. It looks like the enemy team gonna make it back to the keep safely though. So for now, we'll just siege in the back lane. It looks like Illidan doing a weird little counter push there on the other side. For some reason, I can't click on this. I could not click on Li Ming, and it looks like she's gonna finally get taken down. So now we're gonna have to be forced to retreat. We're gonna throw a grenade right there, trying to make sure the enemy team doesn't take us back. We do miss the majority of everybody though, but for now, we did a little bit of damage. We hit out. It looks like Illidan trying to run away. He is full health. So that Immortal, pretty much useless. Don't really get a push. We're still pretty much in the lead because we have a level advantage and we do still have a forward up. But the enemy team completely negating that progress. Maybe we got a couple towers and a door. There we go. But not much else. So good job on them. It looks like a great little poke back there by the Monk revealing Nova. She's forced to go back. Of course, it looks like Fawcett wants to go back here. This time, this is really, really dangerous. Go ahead and keep him alive, thankfully. Oh, can we get to him? Can we go get to him? All right, there we go. I couldn't get to him. I actually picked the wrong target. And for now, I'm going to press that, trying to keep the Monk alive here if we can. But he's taking so much damage that I don't know if he's going to be able to. We're going to try to make it so he can pour to us. Doesn't quite do it. And I am going to try my best to get on here. Of course, Zul picking us up right there. Here comes the grenade, pushing him back. But we're going to get taken down eventually. No problem there. The friendly team finally rotating a little bit too late. Here come Li Ming and Vala. They did get marks on the bottom side, but this push a little too late. As again, Illidan going so deep. If he had just backed up with us, they would have been a little bit afraid of going 3v4, and then maybe they would have gotten away with it. But it's okay. 8 kills to 9. 41,000 damage for the friendly Vala, 37,000 for Sula. I think I'm definitely going to stick with her and try to give her a little bit more stim pack. Because at the very least, she is just chunking people, and that is pretty good. For now, the friendly team opting to defend here. The enemy team cleaning up the bottom push. They're likely to be grinding those pop mercs. There you go. And they're going to be satisfied with just random trade. Of course, we're very much late, so now we got to go defend because we don't have our entire people to try to out DPS. And looks like Li Ming already poking a little bit. Gets a good chunk of damage right there. We do see that Greymane is very low in mana, which is a good opportunity to try and engage here. Of course, Vala trying to poke as hard as she can. And we're going super deep. I don't know what Li Ming is doing. I think she's trying to get Nova out of position, but that is not working out too well in our favor. Of course, the next engagement we need desperately here is another defensive maneuver. Let's go ahead and actually just put that on our friendly Vala just preemptively to make sure that she can chunk people. It looks like she's going to go super deep. Let's go ahead and try to keep her alive because she's the main reason we're going to be doing a lot of this damage. It looks like, oh, Li Ming also taking damage, but we do secure the kill. It looks like the friendly team, now the ones pushing aggressively. Oh, great engagement right there. Can we keep Illidan alive? We are going to press that Q. We're going to keep him on top of that. And we're going to try to keep everybody alive. Li Ming also very low. Illidan going all against the back line. Can't really secure it. Now going for the Monk. Now going for that W on Li Ming. Trying to keep everybody else up. But they're all out of mana. And we are pretty much going to be forced to get out of here. Can't really out DPS anything. We have no mana whatsoever left in the tank. And between myself, Vala, and the Monk, this is not going to be too much. Of course, we got to defend. Defending is the name of the game. We almost catch Nova right there. Trying to do as much as we can to keep this Li Ming in the fight. It looks like finally Vala coming out here. We're doing a lot of damage to Zul. Do we pick up the kill? Yes, we can. And Fawcett with a Windy Gust. But a little bit too late for the enemy team as they're going to be forced to come out here. We're going to be forced to defend, which is not great as I throw a grenade there blindly. Trying to keep ourselves in this game. However, Fawcett doing a good job of poking right there. And For now, I'm gonna be forced to come out here and do a little bit of attacking. We will put ourselves in a good position to sort of engage and draw that damage, but we're gonna be forced back. Of course, tons of damage going on Liming. We do top her off, but we cannot out DPS as it stands right now. I'm gonna continue to keep people down. Of course, Liming going super aggressive. I'm trying to keep her low, but this is gonna be Oshiro, you guys. This is gonna be Oshiro. There's no way we can actually get this guy out of here. Raymond in a lot of trouble though. Can we pick up a kill? It looks like a Maxry grenade picks him up and actually prevents the mounting, but it looks like Nova now jumping on me. And is this a real Nova? No way, okay. So it looks like the enemy team gonna get that immortal. Not a big deal though, we still have the bottom four. Can I make it out of here alive? Yes, I can. And now we're gonna go back to the base, make sure we mana up, and then re-engage. As we look at stats, 11 kills to 10, 53,000 damage for the friendly Vala, 45,000 damage to enemy Zul. Of course, we're at 56,000 healing. Not too crazy, because of course, oh yes, Vala should have gone auto attack build. That's definitely true. Of course, I see that Illidan. See, look at that. He's so low, and he's gonna get chunked by a Q. I really can't do much else to help him. Oh, and just to try my best to show up in time. But even with two support, he's dying way too quickly. A monk can't really palm him. And I wasn't even there for that. So sometimes Illidan, some of you might know, he's sort of considered broken now. We'll see what happens on the patch. Happens tomorrow on Tuesday. Well, today, I guess, on Tuesday, because if you guys are watching this, but still not impossible to counter. And then, of course, it also relies on you being a little bit present with your abilities and with your cooldowns. We're going to try to protect Liming as best we can, trying to throw some max range Qs there and trying to bait, but the enemy team not really baited, as they're going to do the damage they're going to get out. And it looks like so far the chase is real. Liming unable to secure that, and Vala, of course, very, very careful about that. Gets taken down by a clone, but we gotta be very careful about the way we engage you, because of course Falset is coming here. We're gonna try to blow them apart. It looks like he does use a Windy Gust to save himself, and for now we will be content with that, because that would have been a really dreadful engagement that we don't really have that much mana and not much else to do here for the friendly team. Well, then just take these mercs, maybe clean the top lane, and now at level 20 to level 20 we will grab, I think we're going to grab the Caddy's Reaction 2.0 again. It gives us a little bit of shielding. The Simdrone, not really going for best use right now. And it's not like we're auto-attacking a lot. We do have 13,000 damage done, which is not complete garbage, but not as good as we would like. So for the very least now, we'll have a little bit of padding when the enemy team begins to throw. And we might be able to dive after Illidan. That would be a pretty good thing. However, the enemy team does have quite a bit of ZC with Zul and Uther. Of course, Nova can slow me down. So if we go too deep, likely we're going to get taken down before we can do anything. Of course, the friendly team not really caring about those things, getting taken down a little bit prematurely there. And it looks like we'll just be content with topping people off. Let's go ahead and grab that on Illidan if we can. Oh, great gust of wind. Let's go ahead and give him that the shielding, and then just try to keep him alive as long as we can. Of course, the backline getting attacked severely. Everybody taking a lot of damage as we retreat here. The friendly team forced to go back. As you can see, the drone was not that great. So we might as well not use it. Might as well not spec into any more of it. It looks like at the very least we got the bottom push a little bit respectable, which is good, because at the very least the enemy team is going to be forced to deal with that. And for now, we might have this top lane under control for the next 30 or 40 seconds, which might be enough time to go in there and push as severely as we can. Of course, we're one player down. We're going to be forced to flex and defend as best we can. That's the real Nova. That's the real Nova. I don't know why we're not killing her. I'm going to try to come in here and save the friendly Vala, who's going to take a lot of damage. And I'm going to blow this guy back. The Poison Nova, we managed to avoid the majority of that damage. And now we're 1v1ing this guy. But I don't know where my friendly team is. It looks like Illidan finally here in the back. Let's go. Here goes the heals. And remember, we got to keep him alive as long as possible. The friendly team doing a lot of damage. We're also taking a lot of damage. So we're going to come back here. Of course, trying to top off the monk as well, because he is doing the majority of the presence fighting for the friendly team as we continue to throw some grenades max range. Continue to keep everybody low. Of course, Illidan going super aggressive on the other side. We still have mana, which is really good. We pick up yet another kill. Switching positions here with Vala. Trying to make sure we give everybody a little bit of heals, but she's going so deep. And of course, we pick up a double kill on Falset. Now is the time to sort of come in here. It looks like the friendly team able to pick up a couple more kills over there. And now it's imperative that we actually just DPS this guy down as aggressively as possible, because we got nothing else. Let's go ahead and stim Illidan right there. Maybe that'll be able to do enough damage to get this to 50% before the enemy team gets back. We need to make sure we're all topped off. Although, pretty much everybody top mana, I am going to try to keep this Liming topped off a little bit. and we're gonna get in there as fast as possible, make sure we kill the immortal, and then get ourselves back in the lane. Because look at that top lane. Remember I said 40 seconds? Time is about up, and those catapults are gonna begin to push into the keep. So if we're not very careful about the way we pull this off, we might see ourselves taking some core damage. It looks like we managed to do it. And now we're going to go ahead and click the defend. Hopefully, Li Ming will understand. It's like, listen, I'm probably the easiest person to do this with. So we'll do that on the meanwhile, on the bottom lane. We'll try to clean up a little bit, of course. The catapults being the scary thing. I can't really solo DPS this. So I will back away and then maybe let Li Ming know that on the bottom. She also needs a little bit of help. She should be able to clean that up. There we go. And now, 15 kills to 12. Big push. Will this be it? It looks like we have the majority of the shields up for the Immortal. At the very least, we can get those walls. And we should be fine. It looks like Li Ming gonna keep an eye out for the enemy team. They might go core. Core trade would be really preferable for them. Because we will be forced to defend. And they still have a keep to contest with. So they can actually get away with it if they wanted it. Although we are trying to do as much damage as possible, keeping a die there, a damage right there, and healing on Illidan. And here we go, all the healing we can, but he's taking so much damage, and we're going to be forced to come back out here. Oh, another precision strike. You got to dodge that, baby boy. It looks like he does dodge it, and now we're going to just top him off as fast as we can to make sure he can get back in there. Remember, he is the scary one in the composition if he can get within range. Although, let's go ahead and just top the monk off. Here we go. Oh, big stim drone right there. At the very least, we will continue to poke and make sure this thing can get to the core. And that's going to be us for your. That was stressful, but that was pretty cool. 101,000 healing done, 16 kills to 12. The medic, she's awesome. My name is Al. I hope you enjoyed that video, and I will see you all next time.